getting this motor bracket ready to put on, and you know, I painted this thing up, and it's, you know, the same issue as the switch box. You know, these cap holes get gooped up with paint. You just want to run them out. I mean, I would never try to tap with a cordless drill, but just for chasing the threads again, that's fine. Okay, I'm ready to start putting the bracket in place. So here's my bracket mount that's going to bolt to the saw. And you can see there was originally a 10 millimeter bolt that passed through this piece of tubing. And on the inside, there were just two jam nuts. And so I'm going to put this guy here and see if I can't get my holes lined up. I'm a little tight here from the paint. That's okay. Oh, my cross to bear is always making things too tight from just years of woodworking, so. Let's see if I can get this guy. I don't want to damage my threads here. I think that will go. Instead of me banging it, I think I'm gonna turn it with a wrench to keep from damaging those threads. Let me get a socket and I'm gonna turn that. Okay, let me see if I can keep from boogering this guy up. Perfect. So I bought a new bolt because I did tear the other one up. And so this is just actually a loose fit is what this ends up being. There's nothing, this does not have to be tight at all. We want there to be I just jammed those two nuts on the other end, but I couldn't get a 17 millimeter, two 17 millimeter wrenches. And so I had to make a quick and dirty 17. So I did it like that. You know, just made one. Just cut into a, you know, that was old, I don't even know where that came from. Piece of junk, you know, I saved this thin stuff though. Yeah, so this is gonna work out fantastic. Oh yeah, and the reason I had to get a new bolt, that's right, is because this material, 3/8, was thicker than the 1/4 inch ears that came on the original Hitachi. So I didn't have enough threads there to get the two nuts on and be able to jam them. Okay, so let me just use my little homemade wrench. Okay, there. And I think I can reach onto this with this socket. I may have to get a deep well socket. Nope, that's going to work. And that's perfect. Beautiful. Okay, so now I'm ready to mount the other part of the
the bracket, the actual motor hanging portion of the bracket on there. I think I'm going to scooch the motor down a little bit, get it out of my way until I'm really ready to get it in place. Okay, well, hopefully this is going to be the last time this goes on for a long time. So I got these are the camber adjustment bolts. So this side, they're tapped through this 4140 plate. And, you know, normally if this would have just been mild steel, I may have considered using jam nuts instead. But this 4140, this is approximately like what these grade 8 bolts are. So it's some serious stuff. And so I really thank August for sending me this plate. They use it all the time. And it's some really interesting stuff. It's so easy to work, yet it's so tough. So it's a real pleasure to work with. Okay, so you can see here, these are the tapped receivers in the bracket. This is also all 4140, and now these are gonna come in here, and these are gonna allow for lateral adjustment, and then these will go through and hit the plate 4 points, and that's gonna allow me to make a camber adjustment like this, and then this here is the belt tensioner. So wherever I get the belt, you know, sized, and then I can put tension on the belt and just move this thing out and then just jam it against this. And it'll be just the same way the Hitachi was. The Hitachi was the exact same way, where it had a bolt with a jam nut on it. So you could thread it out, tension the swing arm of the bracket, and then lock it. So I didn't see any reason to try to improve upon a really fantastic design. Okay, so let me go ahead and see if I can't get this on without pinching my fingers or something. I think this has to probably go in a little bit more here. And if this bolt may be too long, this is just the only size I had in a high quality grade 8 bolt or heat treated bolt. And I had to clean those slots out too. They were all filled with paint. I just had to run my Swiss Army knife down them. Yeah, this is where you really are glad you spent the time to chase those holes again with the tap, because you know it's a nightmare to try to assemble something like this with a bunch of paint goop down into your threaded holes. So yeah, so I'm able to just get this on here kind of finger tight, and let me get a socket, and then once I get that, then I can just pivot the motor back over here, and it'll just go right in place. Well, I didn't chase these threads. Let me get my half inch tap in the cordless, and let me chase these, because I'm looking in here and I can just see they're filled with paint like crazy.